NGUNNHU.
Trying to rain.
Raining. Where did this come from?
I'm here today to retell a Dreamtime story which was first told to me by Aunty June Barker of Bawarana. The Dreamtime story is about Baiame and the creation of the NGUNNHU at Bawarana. So back in the Dreamtime, before the earth was made, everything was barren. It was dry red earth, and then Baiame came down from the moon and the sun. He went walkabout along the earth and he was creating places everywhere he went. He created Mount Grenfell over at Cobar. He left his footprint in the rocks over there. He'd done the same at Gundabooka, which is at Bourke, and at Byrock watering holes. By the time he got to Brewarrina, he was quite hungry and he noticed down a big water pool with a big black fish in it. So he picked up his spear and he threw it at the fish. He got the fish and the fish was grunting, and he didn't kill the fish, but it made the fish very angry, and he busted through his rock and he took off down along the dry bed, and he was creating troughs and big holes and bends and winds and turns everywhere he went. Baiame chased the fish, but he couldn't catch the fish. The fish ended up getting away. All of the water from the water hole filled the trenches and the bends and the holes that the fish had created. So Baiame, even though he didn't get the fish, he created the river that we have now, and the river sustained the people for many, many years. After this, a certain period, the big dry and famine came, and people around the area, the Nambar people and local Aboriginal people everywhere, they were starving and they had no food, and they didn't know what to do. Baiame had heard about this big dry and the famine, so he and his two sons made the trek back out to Bawarana. When they got here, they were digging up all of these rocks and boulders, and they created a pattern across the river. The pattern ended up being a stone fishnet. Anyway, after the Baiame and his sons had finished the work, still there was no water in the river and there was no rain to be seen. So Baiame grabbed a koolaman and he summoned the older Aboriginal people, men, to come to do some call upon the rains and the rain gods. So the men and Baiame and his two sons, they performed ceremony and had a rain dance for hours and hours. The men were stamping their feet and kicking up the dust, and the ground was rumbling underneath them. This happened for hours and hours. Eventually the men were exhausted and they all fell down and they fell asleep. Whilst this was happening, the dust clouds were still rising very high and they were swirling. And once they got up to a certain height, the Balu, or the moon, found the dust clouds and it started to fill them with water and rain. And then the raindrops started to fall. So for the next 3 or 4 days, the rains fell and the river system was again replenished, and all of the fish traps that were created were filled with water. After a couple of days, when the rain stopped, the water started to subside. The fishermen went down to look at Baiame and his son's creations, and they could see hundreds and hundreds of fish tails and mouths gaping at the water's edge. So they went down with their spears and they started to kill the fish and collect the fish so the people could have a great big feast. They had a great big feast. Baiame went down and he spotted a fish. He spotted one of the little blackfish. As he picked up the blackfish, it was one of the fish that he'd originally speared, and it was grunting. To this day, when the rivers are rising and the fish are biting, you can go down and you can catch one of these little black grunter fish. We know them as black bream, and they're readily available in the rivers today. So that's the creation story that I'm proud to retell for Aunty June Barker.